All right, I'm one of the officials here at the Chrissy Recreational Center. I'm very happy to be a part of this. I'm happy to see the youth out here playing organized basketball, because this is where it starts, the fundamentals. I see we have coaches out here and volunteers, which is good. But more important, they just learn how to play together and keep their mind and focus on the game of basketball, especially since school is out. One thing that I feel that is necessary is to continue to have mentorship from the coaches, from the referees, and the people in the community. Because once you have that organized into one community, it definitely helps the teams to make better decisions in life. The family is closer together, and more important, it keeps them off the streets and away from crime.
Yeah, this is Booby Fauntleroy, Christie's own, Sherwood, The Wood. I'm from this neighborhood. I grew up here. Right now, I'm actually on the off season. I'm a part of the world famous Harlem Globetrotters. And just growing up in this neighborhood, you know, being from here, seeing how, you know, things are, seeing where people have gone and seeing how people have come and gone, you know, it has driven me. You know, drove me to be more focused and to stay focused. You know, I'm wearing my alma mater on my shirt, Mississippi Valley State University. I'm a proud alum, HBCU. I graduated cum laude, 3.3 GPA. You know, I just found different ways and different loopholes in it to motivate myself and keep myself motivated. You know, coming from a messed up family, I wouldn't say messed up, but kind of messed up background, which I get more into in my own personal story, you know, when we shoot it and when we go about filming it. But just keep chasing to anybody in the neighborhood, any kids around the world, wherever this may go, wherever this, whoever may see this, just keep chasing your dream. No matter what you do, don't nobody deter you from what you have on your mind and what you have, you know, you just have to focus. Remain focused and the chase continues. Just keep chasing. That's my motto, keep chasing.
Highlighted, but now we are. But we've never highlighted for the work that we do. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But we give our all, we work hard with these young men. We give them 110% on a regular basis.
We the behind the scene type of guys. Like, you know, I mean, you got the people who always want the spotlight, always want the credit. But then when you can put in some work and stay behind the spotlight, it's the best feeling. Right. 'Cause now you'll get somebody will come to you and say, do you know that kid? He's a great kid. But in the back of my mind, I'm the one that got him that way. Mm-hmm. So I'm not gonna sit there and brag and boast and take all the credit. Right. I'm gonna say, you know what? I know that kid. He's a great kid. But at the end of the day, it's just about the kids. It's not about, oh yeah, I did X, Y, and Z for this kid. Nah, it's about putting in that work. You get finished with him, you go get the next one. And It never stops.
And I always say, if you want to live the next 20 years of your life, you'll come back and give to the youth so they can live the next 20 years of their life, which is very important in this community that we're living in, because we're losing a lot, but we're gaining more when we grab more. Mm-hmm. And that's how we win.
I here at Christy Rec Center, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Been around basketball for pretty much 40 some odd years. Let me see, I'm 54 now, and I started when I was 10 playing basketball, baseball. Back then, everybody played all kinds of sports. Whatever was in season, we played. But right now, mainly coaching, refereeing, things of that nature, trying to get our kids on the right path. Because somebody did it for me, so I have to do it for somebody else. And that's the good thing about, you're going to meet kids to come back and appreciate, you know, not the bank account, not the cars, not the houses, but the kind of person you help mold them into. That's what we here try to do to all our kids, not just the ones that's, you know, a pleasure to be around, the ones that have little problems and issues that they have to work through, to be young men and women. So we're pretty much okay, but we can get better, and that's my aim. Like I said, I've been around sports for pretty much all my life. And it's a good thing. It builds character, friendships, the good, the bad, you know.
City, Philadelphia, North, South, East, West, Germantown, Mount Airy, it doesn't matter. Everybody wants a kid that already knows how to play basketball. Nobody wants to teach a kid how to play basketball. They want the ones that already have talent. So they'll bypass kids that can't jump off the right foot for a layup. Their work happens is so-so. They'd rather play full court, cross you over, go behind their back, between their legs, spin around off their head. They're just trying to learn how to dribble with your right hand, your left hand, what foot to jump off of. Most of them don't even know what foot to jump off of. As far as sports, it's pretty much non-existent for the 10, 11, and 12-year-old. But then in the city, you might find more than out in the suburbs. But everybody has their little bits to make money.
You're gonna be a superstar?
Yes.
You gonna take care of me?
No.
What?
Yes.
You promise?
Yes.
All right, so I want you to have a good practice.
All right. Well,
you ready to warm up?
All hard work equals dedication.
All right, go ahead. All right. Go get it. Go get it, Tiger.
This community program is very good for my son. He's overcome a lot of adversities. We had a house fire where we lost my mother, his twin brother, and a six-month-old brother. And a friend of ours, he opened up his doors to us. So we're really starting from scratch.
He's still an introvert, but basketball seems to be his sport. It brings him out. He wants to be like a Steve Curry, Magic Johnson.
Give me the ball.
Go. We're going to still play Friday.
No, we are.
Yeah, you in old jersey and the shorts. One of the problems I have is the lack of funding. We have volunteers, but they're not trained volunteers. And as far as the lack of funding, everybody has their finger on the check and they don't want to let it go. They just want to keep their finger on it and hold on as long as possible. Meanwhile, we have kids that's not doing anything. And they're sitting around and bad things are going to happen. You know, when kids sit around, they don't do nothing, they'll get bored. And then here comes that bright idea that turns into a crime scene. So that's what we don't want. So if you have any donations, or if you're an experienced coach, hour, a week, 15 minutes out of your time, come on by and say, hey, how you doing? Anything okay? And you know, it'll mean more to them than you giving them a dollar to go to the store to buy a bag of chips and a soda with. Even though more than likely our kids will hit you up. Because that's them. Pay their money, you have shirts and shorts.
Well, ain't the first world game Friday?
Yeah, the first world game is Friday. About that. We
work
that up.
2003 championship, Bartram High School. This is me right here. Back in my days, 12, 13, 14 years ago, I was putting up numbers on all of them. Anybody in the city, they know that name, Ryan Leach. So it's not just, oh, you got the public league title and the Catholic league. It's one big thing now. So the public league might beat the Catholic league and the city title. But back then, they didn't have it when I was playing, because we would have kicked on some of them Catholic teams, but I actually wanted them. But they didn't have it. It was just a city title, which was the public league title. And then they had their own Catholic league title. So, but now they clashing them together. They making it more competitive. And I just wish I was a part of it. But I'm on the sidelines. I'm coaching it now. So I'm good there.
All right, we're setting up for our first game of the season. I just want my guys to have fun, first of all. Second of all, learn something. And don't worry about the wins and losses. Learn something, have fun. That's all.
All right, come on. Get it in here. On three.
Warriors on three. One, two, three.
Set the screen up.
Three, two, one.
Half court, Solomon. Half court. Get in.
Game day down here at Christie Recreation Center. You know, I'm the coach at Boys Latin. Doing a good job right now. We 4-0. We blowing every team out right now. Winning by an average of 25 points a game. Unfortunately, today one of my star players is in a big tournament out in Las Vegas. He wanted to stay here and play today, but I told him it's more important for him to go out Vegas. So right now I'm a little short-handed for my game tonight, which is fine because we got a nice all-around team. In the meantime, I got 2 hours before game day, and this is what I'm out here doing. I'm out here on the pool deck, making sure the kids got a clean pool, put a little chlorine in there for them today. So right now I'm gonna just kick back on my job and wait 2 hours, game day, Boys Latin.
And now
instead of being 2-1, now we're 3-2. And we have the last game of the night. And I know they're going to be tired because most of them play all day in the hot sun. But besides the BS I have to go through with the advisory council, the new supervisor, it seems like they don't like basketball, but we have young men at risk down here. You know, being black and nearby gets you arrested. So we're going to see what happens tonight. Hopefully they'll still play good defense, you know, pass the ball, execute a little better. You know, things should come around. We'll be ready by the time the playoff comes, because we're halfway through the season now. And we should be okay. At least we're learning, we're having fun. That's the main thing. What can I say? My boys are my boys.
Backcourt.
Why'd you do that?
You gotta know when you see that man, you should see yourself. All right, it's too much going on in our communities nowadays, but peace ain't an option. It's not even thought about, man. All right, we gotta wake up, get to know each other, man. That's why we're doing this. How many of you guys know that? If Lou makes that call, respect the call. When you foul, brother, help him up off the ground, man. It's not in person, this is ball. Guess what? After this game, you're gonna go on through life, and you might need some help someday. And guess what? Guess who's gonna wind up helping you? Probably somebody on the other team said, yeah, I ball with that. All right, so this is about relationships and getting to know each other. You got coaches out here, they ain't gotta be out here today. All right, you got refs out here, they ain't gotta be out here today. I could be home with my family, but we out here with y'all. Because we all one big family, you gotta start seeing ourselves like that, all right?
Good afternoon. My name is Don Cave, Director of Outreach for State Senator Anthony Williams here at Family Fun Day, Summer of Peace. This is our fifth year doing it. The method is pretty much to spread love in the community by forcing our young folks to get to know each other through recreation. So the premise is we go from rec center to rec center, bringing in new folks who typically wouldn't frequent that rec center to kind of bury the hatches or just kind of get the folks to get to know each other, in essence, through recreation. It's nothing scientific about it. It's just increase the interactions folks may have, the more they get to know each other, less likely the drama will pop off. So that's what we're about in our community, saving these lives, giving these chances to folks before they can even have a shot. So again, making sure these folks know each other can sometimes save a life. You know, we come from communities sometimes that are that could have been divided for generations, boundary-wise, not necessarily gangs, but just through families. I'm from South Philadelphia. It's quite the fragmentation down there, you know, between different blocks and number blocks. And it's the same throughout the city. So what we figured is, hey, listen, if we can get some of these kids who typically wouldn't come across the tracks, as they call it, or come across this way, to maybe ball, that might be the thing that saves somebody's life. Say, hey, you know what? I know that brother. I played ball with him one time when we were 6 or 7 or maybe 12. So again, man, it's just really to let everybody know that we're out here trying to promote peace in our community, but we just don't talk about it. We put the program behind the recreation. What we do is we reach out to these young folks when they're here to see if they need GEDs, to see if they need drug alcohol help, see if they need food at home, see where they are in school. So it's method behind the madness. We just try to hook them in with the recreation, and then once they're ours, they're ours. You'd be surprised how many of these kids walk away with internships and scholarships out of our office. And again, this is the brainchild of Senator Anthony Williams, who really said, you know, we need to reach the kids where they are and not necessarily need them to come to us. We're going to come to them. This is our fifth year doing this across the 8th Senatorial District, and it gets better every year. And I enjoy doing it because, like I said, it's nothing like going home feeling as though you might have saved a life today in the future. So, again, my name is Don Cave. If we can do anything for you, just reach out to us. We're at the office. We reached at 215-492-2980. And, again, that's State Senator Anthony Williams' office. Take care. Much love and respect.
Enjoying yourself today or whatever, and this is a great community. I've been a volunteer for over 50 years at Christie Recreation Center.
Community right here, this area right here is the number one area of Philadelphia for returning citizens from prison. We the only ones that put the program in the federal Councilwoman Janie Blackwell, so we can clap for that. But we want you to know something. You take a look around this recreation center, it's filled with young people, young positive people.
To the adults, coaches, parents, vendors, I want to thank you all for what you do, not just today. What you do every day. Now you notice Channel 6 is not here, 10, the newspapers, because nothing negative is happening, right? But most important is here today. And because of that, you're gonna be great. I don't know what you're gonna do in life. Doesn't matter whether you're a basketball player or lawyer, it doesn't matter. Long as you do it, with the spirit of love and peace in your heart, then it's gonna work out fine. But I gotta ask one question. Did anybody see that slide out back?
Yes, sir.
Did anybody see that?
Yes, sir.
Did anybody get on that yet?
No, sir.
After it's over, is anybody gonna get on it? I'm not getting on it. It's too hot. I felt a little hot. It's a little bit intimidating. So after the game is over,
you wouldn't notice.
The losers have to get on.
Yeah!
The losers have to
win. Let's go!
The winners may get on. God bless you. Have a great day.
All right. Thank you, Senator Williams. Thank you, sir.
It's almost game time. We had a pretty good season. This is the last regular season. Playoffs are coming up next week. And we're 5-5. And that's not bad considering our age. Our average age is 10, 11 years old. Well, I am kind of rough on my kids, but I want them to be good, strong human beings in society. And I want them to come back and do the same things I'm trying to do. and they can't do it, they're in jail. So with proper funding and, you know, some luck and some parents that, you know, do care about what their kids are doing. You know, some parents are home, but they're not home. And that really, you know, makes it harder on me because I have no relationship with the parent, but I got a relationship with their child. And I have to go because we're about to start another game. Okay? Y'all take care.
We up 44-16. I'm actually subbing for Brian Leach, who's the coach. So to be up big the way we are, it's all due to the coaching. I'm a football coach, but I have the knowledge of basketball. But that's the reason why we up so big, because it's a system. Thank you. Okay.
Hands, hands, fellas. Hands, hands. Y'all see hands. There they go. Easy. That's it. That's good. I'll let it go.
Thank you. This is probably the first time I've been here as an official. It's a very good program. I really enjoy being here. It's different from the other programs because everyone is pretty much respectful. It's family oriented to me, it is. And, you know, I just enjoy being here.
Speaking with Brian Leach here, this league that we got going on here at Christie is a good deal for the kids. You know why? Because it keeps these guys out of trouble. Now, I'm one of the coaches that coach in the league. Got an okay team, not too good, not too bad, so you know. But the best part about it is I get to interact with the kids. Even if I'm not coaching the kids, I get to interact with them. Because that's what I do. Right now, I'm giving back. Once I decided to retire from basketball, I started giving back. So now I'm coaching. The best thing in the world, to help kids. I never had it growing up, had people on your back telling you the rights and wrongs. I was just the type of kid that just knew the rights and wrongs. But nowadays, in this generation, you gotta be there for these guys because their parents not around, they might not have a male figure. And being though, I'm a father or two. I don't want my kids running around wild. I want somebody to stop them if they see them. So that's what I'm out here doing. It's about leading these guys in the right direction. And this basketball league at Christie is great for the community because now instead of kids climbing on the roofs, they got stuff to do inside the gym. They can come in, they can watch a game, they can play in games. Rather than 2 years ago, it's kids, you can hear their footsteps on top of the building. So, I mean, at the end of the day, it's all about the community. And the league is great right now. Playoffs, Final Four is getting heated up right now. My team made it to the Final Four. Hopefully we can get a win tonight. I mean, if not, it's still about me teaching and learning. Like, it's all about the kids right now. I mean, if we lose, okay. I still know that I made an impact on not only my team, the whole community, because now, kids want to come to Boys Latin now. And that's a plus for me. I'm out of here.
season's over. They played well. They played hard. They did a lot better than I thought they would. But we're young, but we're good. That's it.